make us dozen.
And who might you be? Bravo. Great job, Zuffa. Great job, George St. Pierre. Great job, the Fertittas. And ultimately, great job, Dana White. People don't believe in conspiracy in MMA. People don't believe that certain fighters, people have it out for. Nick Diaz is a free thinker, a free speaker, a great fighter, but they do not want him to represent the company as UFC's welterweight champion. I'm not here to break down the fight. I'm not here to recap UFC 143. I'm here to pretty much just explain, coming from Nick Diaz, number fucking one fan, not newly either. I've been a fan of the motherfucker for a minute, as you all know. This isn't a breakdown of UFC 143 or the fight. This right here is a breakdown of why they don't want Nick Diaz to pretty much hold the title that he won this past Saturday. On what planet do you win four rounds out of five? Your opponent runs the entire fight. You're running them down, stalking them, hitting them with harder shots. And the fucking track star gets the nod. He gets the decision win. A lot of people are saying that Nick Diaz won round one, round two. And it's always after, they keep saying after rewatching, that Nick Diaz did win round one, two, and five. The fight that I saw, the fight that I've watched four times, Nick Diaz won round one, round two, round three, and round five. In what world do you give the nod to the person that he's stalking, to the person that's running away the entire fight? Carlos Condit was a fan of you, but in that, you said it was going to be a dog fight. I know a game plan is a game plan, but that was the most pussy game plan that I've ever seen in my entire life. To throw one punch or one kick and fucking run off. One punch, run off, plant your feet, and start over again. That was the most bitch move I've ever seen in fucking any fucking fight. And like I said, I couldn't do the video right away, man, because I've been fucking steaming over this shit. I've been steaming over this shit, and y'all know how I am, bro. Y'all know what the deal is. If a Nick Diaz fight is coming on tomorrow, I'm getting ready the day before. Preparation, homie. like everything, like every corporation, like every big company, they don't want a free-thinking, opinionated person to represent their company. They want someone that pretty much a robot, like a George St. Pierre, someone with no personality, no backbone, someone that's not going to say what's on their mind. That's the reason why they hate on BJ Penn a lot in the UFC. But the way it is, they want someone that's pretty much just going to be like a robot, like, what's next for you? You want to call anybody out? I pretty much just whatever the UFC wants me to do next, I'll be there. That's what they want. They want those guys. And Nick Diaz, he knows the fight that he wants. He knows the fight that the fans want, and the fans do want the fight. But that shows you too how little the UFC, Dana White, all them faggots give a shit about what the fans want to see. It's the only fight that makes sense. But like I said, for what it is, I'm getting off subject. They want robots, period. Operation Decapitate, Nick Diaz worked. They got him out of there. They took his want to fight MMA away. And now you got everyone that was part of it trying to save face. You have George St. Pierre tweeting that he hopes one day he can meet Nick Diaz in the octagon, which is total bullshit. He wants no part of that. You have people like Joe Rogan, in which was anti-Nick Diaz the entire time he called that fight. He only picked out
what Carlos Condit did. As soon as they signed Nick Diaz, Operation Decapitate was in motion, and the fight didn't go the way they wanted it to, but in judgment, they're paying them dudes. They're paying them guys, man, and that bitch. They're paying them.
Did you notice the entire fight, as Nick Diaz is walking them down and landing power shots, they only picked out what Carlos Condit did. It was a few combos. It was hilarious. Like, Nick Diaz went, like, Goldberg picked it out. Nick Diaz went to the body and then hit him with a straight to the thing, snapped his head back. Nice combo by Nick Diaz. Immediately after he said that, Joe Rogan, oh, but right before that, Carlos Condit landed a sweet leg kick. I'm like, so he lands a body shot, snaps his head back. You talking about the leg kick right before. Ridiculous. Like I said, that shit was a fix. I don't give a fuck what anybody says. It is what it is. I mean, what are you going to do about it? As far as Nick Diaz retiring from the game, I don't blame him. I don't fucking blame him. Every fight that he loses fights by decision. He wins fights by stopping motherfuckers and by effectively pummeling on their fucking face, like the BJ Penn fight. And even in that fight, at the end, he's like, I won that shit. I won that shit. You know why he said that? Because he could fucking understand that the judges could fuck him, screw him over just for the fact that they can do it. That's why he got all fucking crazy emotional after that fight. Because he know, like, that it was in the bag for him this fight. If you notice, when they had the close-up on him, it was nothing but confidence. That's how I was. I was like, bet, hell yeah, it's in the bag. What are they going to do now? It has to happen, George St. Pierre. Stop being a fucking faggot. And you could see it in his face. He was like, yeah. And then he even looked at the king. He was like, yeah, what's up, George? What's up, George? Because it was in the bag. Anyone that fucking watches the fight knows. I mean, fucking for all these idiots saying that Condit won three, give him three. It's still 1, 2, and 5, the fucking two rounds. In no planet, in no fucking situation, Carlos Condit won that fight. Fuck you, UFC. Fuck you, Zuffa. Fuck Dana White, George St. Pierre. Fucking fuck you with fucking silver rocks. I don't even know what that means, but you're a bitch. You deserve fucking 10 million cocks fucking in your face. One in the ear, one in the ear, one in the mouth, two in the nose, nostrils. Fucking poke your eyeballs out. Throw a few cocks in there, too. George St. Pierre, you a bitch. No respect for you, Carlos Condit. You were one of my favorite fighters. Natural born killer. Natural born motherfucking treadmill fucking associate. Nigga. Nigga. Carlos Condit. Fuck. He fought that fight how Barry Sanders used to run away from linebackers. That shit was bullshit. And I do, like, the game is fucked. And like I said, if it wasn't for the UFC coming to Atlanta, UFC 145, John Jones and Rashad Evans, I wouldn't watch the UFC for a minute. I have to be there. Like I said, I may go with a bullhorn, a Nick Diaz shirt, and a fucking fist clench, ready to fucking knock Chael Sonnen the fuck out if I see him. Is what it is, what it ain't, what it's gonna be. Ceremony tonight. Stay tuned.
Another thing to think about. The UFC and Zuffa's funded by the Fertittas, which is a huge mob family that's in gaming. They own casinos. Nick Diaz wasn't an underdog for one time in a fight. Carlos Condit was. A lot of people won a lot of money in high places. And also, why the fuck are they trying to initiate a fight with Nick Diaz and Josh Koscheck? Who wants to see that fight? It's ridiculous. They're trying to set him up for, once again, another failure. They're trying to set him up for a fight to where someone's not going to fight him. They're going to try to take him out and pretty much place a George St. Pierre game plan on Nick Diaz. That way, pushing him out of the UFC if he were to lose that fight, which he wouldn't. Another thing, why have him fight someone that they gave a chance at George St. Pierre? Why the fuck can't he get his crack at George St. Pierre? George St. Pierre, he claims he wants to put a beating on Nick Diaz. If the fight ever goes down, Let's see if George St. Pierre fights the same fight that he fought Josh Koscheck. He stood up with another wrestler. Why can't he stand up with a Nick Diaz? He said he wants to put a beating on him. That's a beating. He gave George St. Pierre gave Koscheck a beating. George St. Pierre, give that beating to Nick Diaz when the fight happens. Pussy. That will be all. Nick Diaz, number one fucking fan. Shout out Bloodstained Lane. Shout out Nick Diaz. Shout out Nate Diaz, Cesar Gracie. Everyone that has to do with a real fucking fight and a real fucking fighter. Carlos Condit, that suck a fucking dick. Also, shout out to that Persian wheelbarrow imported from Persia. $10 million. I paid $10 million for a wheelbarrow, nigga. Who do you know pays $10 million for a freaking wheel? That grass right there, imported from France. That's Jamaican seagrass. Shout out to that wheelbarrow. Canada Dry. Oh, where are you leaving? Who are you? Who are you to interrupt this video, mother?